All right, hello and welcome. You're now watching FII and we are doing a special YouTube section only for our YouTube viewers at this point because all of you have sent in so many questions that you wanted experts to take on. So let's just dive in straight into that. We've got Sheetal Kapoor and Anil Chopra will be taking all your questions. Mr. Chopra, first question to you. This is from Deepak. He says, please explain the difference between health insurance and COVID insurance.
Right. So good question. Obviously, COVID is a new, word or term which we have learned only last 7-8 months. So, of course, nobody knew anything about COVID 2 years ago or 5 years ago. So, all the old health insurance policies that we have, none of them mentions COVID as something which is covered. Mm. And after the pandemic started, then initially when people got into COVID and they went for claims, then there were some insurance companies which were refusing to admit saying that COVID was not covered. Then IRDA had to step in and IRDA mandated no nothing doing. All existing health insurance policies will have to cover COVID, whether it is mentioned or it is not mentioned. Simultaneously, IRDA mandated every insurance company to come up with corona specific policies. So that's how we have that corona coverage and corona rakshak, these two policies. Mm. So the difference between a normal health insurance plan and a COVID plan is that normal health insurance plan covers all diseases, including corona. Whereas if you have a corona plan, it covers only and only corona and nothing else.
Right. So that should sort out that. Let me take the next question to you, Sheetal. This is from Akshit Soni. He is from Panipat in Haryana. He says, claiming insurance is one headache that people go through. Do you think a scam?
Okay, so yeah, we all know that when someone wants to buy insurance, how agents are behind them that, you take insurance, you will get these benefits and these benefits. But when you have to claim, then comes the exclusion part that this is not covered and this is not covered. So, there is a lack of transparency in the system is what, we know about it and we should do something on it. With Oxy, what we did was coming up with a transparent system. There are no claims, nothing. You get it, whatever it is, or at the hospital. So I would, as a normal citizen of the country, I would want all the insurance companies to also do that. Again, paperless world we are living in at the moment. Then why not the claims? Why not the claims be transparent as it is? You just go, if you have an ailment, you're going to an hospital, you're paying a premiums. You're not, asking for any kind of a charity or something like that. You are asking for premiums. So, you go there, get your claim settled on the spot. Why you have to pay and then, go out running behind the insurance companies that, you pay me back what I have gone through. Of course, I think we need some difference over there.
We need more work on that front. Mr. Chopra, next question. This is by Indy007. The question is, best policy which covers all expenses for a COVID hospital and home treatment expenses? Would you recommend?
Yeah, that's a good question because most of the health insurance plans do not cover home treatment. I'm sure everyone knows that one has to be hospitalized for at least minimum 24 hours in 95% policies to get any kind of claim. Mm. But because COVID, it has actually spread like pandemic and there is a shortage of beds and ventilators and all that stuff. So that is why IRDA mandated that even home treatment should also be covered. And that is why this beautiful policy called Corona Kavach is the only policy which actually makes you reimburse even the home treatment expenses also. Hmm. But the maximum coverage is for 5 lakhs and it also includes consumables like PPE kit, like mask, like sanitizers, like gloves, which no other health insurance policy covers. So that's why this Corona Kavach, it actually helps you because 80% of the corona cases are being treated at home and only 20% are being treated at hospital. And because the government and the entire healthcare infrastructure wants, people to be treated at home. So that is why home treatment was made it specifically inclusive.
Mr. Chopra, then that people who don't have health insurance right now and are a little paranoid about COVID, this is something they can get to start with. Just get comfortable with that idea, see how the process is, and then perhaps in better days, when you're out of the pandemic, they can shift to a long-term plan.
That's right. You see, if people are already having health insurance policies and if they have been told that corona is also covered, but then probably they do not know that home treatment is not covered in the old health insurance policies. So in order to cover home treatment, it is so much advisable to go for a corona coverage policy, which is just 3,000 rupees, for a 5 lakh cover for a 50-year-old person. So if the person is only 20-year-old, then of course the cost is even 1,200, 1,300. So just to think about 50 or plus people, the cost is only 3,200 for a 5 lakh policy, and it covers your home treatment even up to 10-12 days, including the consumables which I already mentioned, like PPE kit, mask and sanitizers, etc.
Let me ask you a second question, which is sort of related, which I asked Sheetal as well earlier. This is from TJ, and he's saying many private hospitals are denying insurance and asking cash for treatment of COVID-19. That creates a situation of distrust in the health insurance industry in the middle of a pandemic. What is the solution to this problem? Very easy. Well,
naturally, you know, such cases need to be brought to the notice of ombudsman, need to be brought to the notice of IRDA and to the insurance companies. Because when you take the policy, along with the policy, you get a list of some 2,000-3,000 hospitals, you know, where the cashless treatment would be done. That is, you know, as per the promise given. If those hospitals which are now refusing to accept the claims are part of those list of 2,000 or 2,500 cashless hospitals, then definitely, you know, a voice needs to be raised, a case needs to be filed, and that needs to be brought to the notice.
If I have a problem, what can I do? Can I write an email to IRDA, or how does it work?
Oh, you have so many, you know, remedies available. Straight away, first of all, you can help. The hospital is not ready to accept your claim. You can go to the insurance company and to your agent and one, instruct the hospital to accept it or shift the hospital. And also, you can go to IRDA, and then finally, you can also go to Ombudsman, where the email, you know, one simple email will start the entire machinery into function, that they will take immediate action. So there are a lot of remedies which are available.
Okay. Sheetal, next question is coming from Bihar. This is from Jay Prakash Thakur. He's written, how can a family like ours, which is from a small town, even get a good medical facility? So what will be done with medical insurance? So is this becoming a very metro problem? I think it's a very valid question of what happens to smaller towns where there is already a big question mark over health facilities to start with.
Yeah, so first of all you see, I come from a background where, you know, we have a new age kind of a health thing for the people. And new age is not only for metros, it's for everyone. First is they need to see what is the network around them. With coming up is like 1,000, 2,000 only in the metros, or, you know, 5,000 hospitals spread over Delhi, Mumbai, all the metros and all the A-grade cities, or also in the, you know, the smaller towns or the smaller cities. First, they should look at the network that they have. Like, we have about 2 lakh hospitals, which hospital diagnostic pathologies. We cover everything from a fever to something which is called an ICU treatment. So one, everyone should look in what is...
So your network should be local? Is that what you're trying to say?
Yeah, exactly. Yes, you know, you won't never, anyone would travel, you know, 10 kilometers or 20 or 20 miles for some treatment or a doctor consultation. They would never go. They would go to a nearby or the neighborhood hospital or the neighborhood clinic. And they should take a plan which has that center or that clinic or that diagnostic or pathology into their network. All right. So for all the smaller city kind of people, focus on the network first.
Right. Mr. Chopra, last question. This is from Surya. He actually sent out 4 questions, but I'll read one question which he haven't covered. He says, is there any different plan that has come for critical COVID-19 people who are in home quarantine? And he also asks how to choose overseas travel insurance, especially in the times of COVID-19.
Right. So these are 2 different questions. Obviously, as far as corona is concerned, the corona-specific plans are only 2 as of now, as mandated by IRDA, Corona Kavach and Corona Rakshak. Mm. Corona Rakshak requires hospitalization, minimum 3 nights. Mm. And it is simply on detection. So if you are detected corona positive, and if you spend 3 nights in a hospital, you get 2.5 lakhs straight away, whether the expense is 50,000 or 5 lakhs. So that is Corona Rakshak.
Okay.
But Corona Kavach is 5 lakhs. There, even home treatment is also included, as I mentioned earlier. But their actual amount spent would be reimbursed, whether it is, if it is less than 5 lakhs, the whole amount. If it is more than 5 lakhs, maximum 5 lakhs can be reimbursed. That is Corona Kavach. Mm-hmm. But talking about overseas medical insurance, first of all, these days, when we have the pandemic, we know that there are so many restrictions on overseas travel, and only specific type of people only can, you know, travel from India to outside or outside to India. Mm-hmm. So obviously, there are certain countries where it is mandatory to carry a specific amount of health insurance cover, even up to $50,000 or even up to $100,000. There are certain countries. So wherever country is going, whenever he takes a visa, he would be told that you must carry a X amount of minimum health insurance, overseas travel insurance, and that will and should cover COVID, because globally it has been
accepted. You have some recommendations for people who are traveling in these times?
Yes, if you are talking about the name of the company, then as a business house, we have studied all the different overseas travel insurance policies, and we recommend Tata AIA.
All right,
for travelers, and we recommend $100,000 for US and $50,000 for other countries.
All right, Mr. Chopra, Sheetal Kapoor, thank you so much for taking out those questions. That's all we have on the YouTube segment today for all our FII viewers. If you also have a question or if you have an issue you want us to raise on the program, do write into us. Just hashtag FII or tag me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, and we'll get your experts in various fields to answer those for you. Thank you so much for joining us.